You know, that propeller's got a lot of strength to it. I'm putting some pressure on it, and it's still going with a good breeze. Well, I like my curtain rod idea, but this curtain rod that I bought for 94 cents, it's a little bit flimsy. Works though. They think I'll buy a little bit more heavy duty curtain rod. Anyway, that's the way I made it. I took a glue gun, glued my sail right in that groove, put my screw down in here. I've got a piece of a curtain rod in the basement that's much more stiffer, so I know they make a heavier one. I'll get a bigger, heavy one, whatever that's got less flex to it. If anybody wants to make one of these, there's not a whole lot to it. But you can invest a little bit of money. You're going to need a couple of Coke bottles, some nuts and bolts, some kind of metal. That flat metal works real good over there, but it's more expensive. Good day, my friends. Walter here. Tinkering around out here in the yard today. I had to water my hydrangeas. Looking all wilted. It's like somebody broke it or stumped it over, but maybe it just needed water. I've been making a lot of these whirligigs lately. Not really a whirligig because I haven't put any adaptations on here for any figures to move. Well, here's one I made last night. This one here I made for a lady in Barnesville, Georgia. Made one for my daughter, already gave it to her. This metal rod I made for my daughter was made out of a curtain rod. But one of her friends, an old lady down there, saw it. Said, that's pretty neat. I'll give him $20 for one of them. I said, yeah, I'll make her one. But I think I've got darn near that invested in time and effort or more. It's probably worth $25. I bought some 1x2s at Lowe's yesterday to use for my post. Saw some tomato steaks over there, and they were like $7.95 for a square stick. For that price, I'll buy some 1x10s or something and slice them up my own little square. But anyway, I made this one with that old lady. Maybe some of her friends will see it and order one. I might be in the money-making deal here, but the price is going to go up to $25. I didn't drive that stick in the ground very good. It's only in there about an inch or two because I got to give it to that old lady. Different kind of frog on that one, but it works pretty good. This is a Diet Right bottle with alcohol ink on it. The one I gave my daughter was seemed like it had a blue propeller on it. There's one I made there. There's one there. This one's got a red bird on it. That one's got a different kind of frog. Same kind of frog over here made with a Sprite bottle. I need to cut another 1x2 and put out here. I might just move this propeller out here. I like the one I painted today better than I do that plain one. And one of my wife's friends wants one too. I told her I'd make her one. I've got to be careful about giving all the free ones away. The friends will get one. But it takes about, all total, it probably takes me an hour and a half or 2 hours of my time to make these things. But they work really neat. It's kind of like a weather vane, wind direction. Yesterday they were turned around this way, so I knew the wind was coming from that away. We just got back in town, had to go pick up some medication. And I noticed something I thought I'd mention in today's vlog. Sometimes you can go to town and not see one single police car. It's pretty clean out here. My wife squirted off the porch with a hose today because the pollen was just ridiculously thick out here. But you can go to town and see not one single police car. Today we went up to Walmart and we saw at least 7 Griffin police pulling people over. Now, it's, you know, you might see 1 or 2 occasionally. Sometimes you go to town, you might not see any police pulling somebody over. But when you see 7 or 8 police cars pulling people over on one trip to Walmart and back, you know the city of Griffin's making a concerted effort to stop people and ring up some money for their cash register. Well, on the way back, we saw about 3 or 4 of them on the way back from Walmart. And you know how sometimes you see a police car off in the distance and you see the blue light flashing? Well, you think, oh, some poor fool's getting a speeding ticket. And what you don't know in Griffin, Georgia is you're the one fixing to get a ticket. I saw it today and I didn't realize it. That's the first time I've really seen that. It was a woman policeman. She pulled out there and got her turned on her blue light. The light's flashing like crazy. So you would assume when you're coming up the road, somebody else has already been stopped. That ain't true. She's just sitting there with her light flashing, got her radar gun pointed out the window, taking you a picture just pretty as please when you come by. And that is slick. Turn on your blue light so you'll think somebody else is in trouble, and you the one getting ticketed. That's slicker than Al droppings. I'm going to get my pliers and put this on my Whirligig out there. Tonight I'll probably make another one. Let's see, all total, let's see, I made one for my daughter. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I've made at least 6 of them already. And my little propellers work amazingly well. Anyway, if you're in Griffin, Georgia today, you better mind your P's and Q's, because they're ranking up some. A few kills with the radar machines today. Waiting for the rain to come. It's supposed to come downpour. You know what? I like the ones that I made with only using a half of a cutting board better than I do this one here that I used a whole cutting board on. So I'm going to carry it back down to the workbench and change that sail to a half a cutting board. And while I'm at it, I'll put this propeller on there. Now I suspect other people are going to be asking me to make them one too. Anyway, the price is going up to $25. I could mass produce these things and sell them on the old internet, I reckon. The problem about selling something online, you can't ship for free. It makes your price go up when you have to charge people shipping and handling. Yeah, I'm going to take this one and change it to a half a sail. Well, I got that one swapped over to a smaller sail, and the rain has begun. Thanks for listening, my friends.